Myth. Illusion. Lies. Scam. For some years now, the press has been full of negative comments about the plastics recycling process. But despite the relevance of these criticisms, recycling projects are multiplying around the world. This situation proves that few people are really aware of the problems. For example, here in Switzerland, plastic waste is used to make road surfacing, or cycle paths in Holland. In India, plastic bags are used to make drinking water cubes, or paving stones for terraces and outdoor paths. Ghana also has cobblestones. In the Ivory Coast, we make bricks to build schools. In Korea, we make furnitures. And synthetic fibers are used to make clothes. In Kenya, bricks, tiles, boat repair parts. More tiles in Somalia. Here in Brazil, bottles are cut up to make brooms. Corks are crushed to make skateboards. In France, we make glasses or bath toys. In a nutshell, and the list goes on, there's no shortage of ideas for giving plastic waste a new lease of life. And you, for that matter, are you one of those people who buy or even make these kinds of objects from the transformation of plastic waste? You know, those things that are sold as recycled to save humanity and the planet from pollution? I'm really interested in who you are. Please tell me in the comments. So why are scientists and journalists sounding the alarm about this type of recycling? Why isn't this the perfect central solution for tackling global pollution? Well, with my channel, I'm going to answer you right away to help you understand this complex problem. And if you have any questions on this subject after this video, don't hesitate to leave me a comment and watch my other videos. You can also subscribe to my channel and tell me if you liked what you saw and learned with me. To begin with, the term recycling is not well known and therefore not widely used. When you hear recycling, you might think of that logo with the three arrows that look alike and follow each other to draw an infinite loop. For the record, this symbol was inspired by the Mobius ribbon. When you move on this ribbon, wherever you start from, if you run the whole length of the ribbon, you'll always come back exactly where you started. Each round is a cycle and each cycle is identical to the first. It's a good reason to use this symbol to represent recycling. Whatever its position along the ribbon, a recycled bottle will always be a bottle, identical or virtually identical to the original one. A little further on, there's another bottle that's almost identical. Recycling is an ongoing reformulation of what we had at the start. But when it comes to plastics, there is a terrible misunderstanding because true recycling is impossible for most of them. In an article published in 2022, French scientists proposed the following definition, which I will simplify for you. Operation by which waste is reprocessed into very similar materials with the same original purpose and function. True recycling works well for glass, metals, and paper. But on the other hand, very few plastics could form part of a perfect infinite loop among the millions of tons of waste produced around the world every year. And that's why it's such a big problem. As you saw at the beginning of this video, plastic waste is used to produce everything else. Tiles, bricks, glasses, toys, stools, clothing. And yet these people are talking about recycling. So they're either misinformed or dishonest. But why? Well, take for example the production of fleece from bottles. Here, the fabric obtained is very different from the bottles and is no longer recyclable. So this jacket will never give back the bottle.
But all these objects made from recycled plastics can't be recycled afterwards. So your fleece jacket made from recycled plastic, your garden chair, well, it's going to continue to age and it's going to continue to feed this huge reservoir of microplastics and nanoplastics that we're building up. So we're not making pollution disappear. You all agree, don't you?
So this jacket breaks up into tiny plastic dust that forms during manufacture, during use, during each wash, and finally during storage in a landfill. And this dust will fly off to contaminate the air you breathe, the water you drink, and the oceans and soil that feed you. Only to end up where we've already found them. In the lungs, in the intestines, in placenta, in breast milk. more recently in human hearts, and certainly soon in brains. So, if this transformation process isn't recycling, what is it? Well, there's another word for it, downcycling.
What we call recycling is actually downcycling, and that seems to be taboo, not to be said.
Here is a version of the definition proposed by the same scientists, operation by which waste is converted into lower quality materials. So from now on, you won't be fooled by those who abuse the term recycling. These people, whether dishonest or clumsy, give the impression that the quality of their plastic products is great for the planet. But it's not true, and it's serious. Today, the misuse of the word recycling allows certain solutions to be marketed that are of no benefit to the environment and potentially toxic to humans, and which should be punishable by law. To finish with the vocabulary, you may also have heard of upcycling. The main difference with recycling is that in upcycling, the object is used as it is. For example, make flower pots from old tires. The object will be improved for reuse. But plastic objects produced by upcycling will eventually end up as final waste in nature, and therefore in plastic dust that will contaminate us. And that's it. To sum up these three concepts of transformation, you can just remember that in recycling and downcycling, there is a notion of destroying in order to make something new, identical or completely different. In upcycling, the object is used as it is, but this second life is only temporary. These downcycled and upcycled items always wear out over time. As they are used and washed, they produce toxic dust that contaminates your environment and your body. For the rare PET bottles that are recycled into bottles, this is unfortunately only possible once, twice, or three times.
Today's plastic is not made for this, because it is a material that interacts, degrades, and deteriorates, so it cannot be recycled. So the limits are rapidly becoming apparent. The best existing recycling method is therefore the PET bottle, which becomes a PET bottle again a limited number of times. And the plastic must not be too damaged. It must not be too contaminated. So you need a very precise collection circuit. It's very complicated.
As the quality of the plastic deteriorates with each reprocessing. And what's more, most of the time, they're lost in the wild anyway, even before they've been retransformed the first time. Once lost in nature, these PET plastics become so damaged and dirty that they can no longer be recycled. And now you can see where they'll end up. Let's now look at the other major problems linked to the toxicity of the objects produced by these processes, which destroy before creating new objects. I'm going to tell you about the Greenpeace USA report entitled Forever Toxic. This report was published in 2023. And it explains very well the origins of the toxicity of new objects resulting from recycling and downcycling processes. Firstly, the toxic chemicals in the new plastics. When an object is made by recycling old plastics, the various toxic chemicals in the old objects that have been crushed and melted mix together. The recycling process can therefore intensify chemical threats. A study published in 2022 in an international journal shows that new bottles made from recycled plastic contain higher concentrations of toxic chemicals than bottles made from new plastics. Secondly, the mixing of toxic substances in plastic waste. Plastic packaging can be contaminated by adsorption of the chemicals it is used to store. Pesticides, herbicides, cleaning products, and medicines, for example. This contamination is also spread between objects at waste collection centers during transport of waste or during final storage after sorting and before processing.
Thirdly, the new toxic substances created by plastics recycling.
When plastics are reshaped into other objects, new toxic chemicals can be formed. For example, benzene can be created during the shredding of polyethylene terephthalate with contamination from polyvinyl chloride. And even if there is very little PVC contamination, the new plastics are contaminated with a carcinogenic chemical, according to the European Union. You can easily find information on its toxicity on the internet to check. I've read that benzene is irritating to the skin, that it causes superficial eye damage, that repeated exposure can cause neurological and digestive disorders, that effects on reproductive organs are also known. The scientists who studied this benzene also found that this unintentionally added substance migrates into the drinks in the new bottles, and that this migration is stimulated by temperature. So don't leave your bottles lying around in the sun. On the other hand, you'll never know if the bottle you've bought has been left out in the sun during transport or storage. And even if this migration is in very small quantities, there is still no standard on acceptable quantities of benzene for human health, as required by legislation on materials in contact with food. The processing of plastic waste therefore encourages the concentration and formation of toxic chemicals, which can then migrate and contaminate the liquid in the new can, the packaged food, or the air in your home from the new objects you buy. In a recent study carried out in Kenya by the International Pollutant Elimination Network, a toy car contained more toxic chemicals than the ashes from the waste-burning site.
Blimey!
Fourthly, the processing of plastics can contaminate the environment, workers, and the food chain.
As well as producing contaminated objects, Greenpeace tells us that harmful chemicals pollute the air inside and around plastics processing sites. Logically, this external pollution should decrease as you move further away. A study carried out by the International Pollutant Elimination Network even found that the eggs of hens reared in the vicinity of plastic and electronic waste recycling sites were more polluted than elsewhere. Indoors, this pollution contaminates workers, especially in countries where workplace safety rules are more flexible. Greenpeace points out that workers in plastic recycling plants are exposed to higher health risks, such as cancer. And in 2023, a study revealed the presence of a toxic chemical, a flame retardant, in the food and environment of recycling workers in Thailand. In the blood of a plastics worker, a 280-fold higher concentration of this chemical was even found, compared with the blood of agricultural workers living 15 kilometers away. Finally, plastic recycling sites are very often subject to major fires. It may come as a surprise, but yes, plastic waste storage sites for recycling are going up in flames all over the world. In the United States and Canada, 390 fires were recorded in 2022. In Turkey, the number of fires rose from 33 in 2019 to 121 in 2021. That is one every 3 days. In Malaysia, there were twice as many fires in 2022 as in 2021, again at plastics recycling sites. In short, recycling sites around the world are going up in flames. Australia, Ghana, Russia, Taiwan, Thailand, United Kingdom, Belgium, France, Greece, India, Austria, and the list goes on. And these fires, with their toxic fumes, can cause respiratory problems for local populations, trigger and aggravate asthma, cause skin rashes, and eye damage. These fumes also carry persistent carcinogenic compounds such as dioxins and furan, as found in Greece in 2015. And these compounds contaminate soil and water, and then humans, mainly through contaminated food. Known toxic effects are linked in particular to an increase in cancers of blood, lungs, and liver. And the fumes, but also the ashes from fires, contaminate the area around plastic recycling sites indefinitely, the soil and local residents, and increase the risk of cancer. Now, I hope you understand the nuances behind the terms recycling, downcycling, and upcycling. And whether you are one of those who buys or manufactures objects made from recycled plastic, you now know that this is not the solution to saving humanity, nor the planet from pollution, which is clearly an insidious, invisible, and persistent pandemic. And I really hope that you won't be fooled again by those who dishonestly or clumsily use these terms to sell you a dream that hides what is certainly a toxic nightmare.
A lie,
a swindle,
a myth,
an illusion,
a curse, a hoax.
Right, that's it. Don't forget to share this video with anyone who tries to convince you that recycling is great.
No.
Well,
ciao.
And take good care of yourself.
Ciao.
And take good care of yourself.